Thank you all for coming. I'm Silvia García, I'm project manager at CNTA, and I'm the coordinator of the HISTER project, and I'm going to introduce you the project, our main objectives and results. Then first of all, what's high pressure and temperature technology? This treatment involves subjecting the food to a range of very high pressure transmitted by water, normally between about 300 to 600 megapascals for some minutes. This pressure is transmitted uniformly and instantaneously throughout the product to inactivate bacteria. Then, if this treatment is applied at room temperature or temperatures below 50 degrees, the main target of the treatment are vegetative pathogen and spoilage microorganisms, yeast and moths, but spoilated microorganisms are not inactivated by this technology. Then the storage conditions and shelf life that we can obtain when we treat food products at room temperature depend on the physicochemical characteristics of these products. For acid products, we can store them in cold storage or ambient or at a room temperature depending on their pH, but low acid food products should be stored in cold conditions and up to 10 days if there are not other barriers present in the product, as very low temperatures or preservatives or low water activity. The quality of the food products treated by this technology, by high pressure at room temperature, are very high because we can maintain the color, the flavor, the nutrients present on the raw materials. Then we can obtain very high food quality products, and there are now available at the market several products treated by this technology. But when we combine high pressure with temperature above this 70 degrees, the target could be also spirulated microorganisms. Then in this case, the storage conditions and shelf life that we can obtain with this combined treatment depends on the intensity of the treatment. If we apply temperatures up to 90 to 100 degrees, we can inactivate psychrotrophic spores. Then we can obtain products stable at cold conditions for several weeks or even several months. But if we increase this temperature and we apply temperatures above 100 degrees, we can inactivate mesophilic and even thermophilic, some thermophilic spores, and then we can obtain low acid food product stable at room temperature. Then this is why the reason, the main advantage of this technology. We can inactivate with this combined treatment spores microorganisms. Regarding the quality of food product, the expected quality of food product with this combination, this is the thermal load of a thermal treatment in a retort. This is a typical thermal treatment in a retort. Then the thermal load is quite high. And this is the thermal load that we can expect when we apply high pressure and temperature technology. Then the thermal load, we have here two main advantages. First of all, the fast heating and cooling due to the compression and the decompression. And then we can expect around 30 degrees when we go up to 600 megapascal, around 30 degrees. And also another advantage is that we can use less temperature and or time due to a synergistic effect between the high pressure and the temperature regarding the microbial inactivation. And due to this reason, the thermal load of the HPT treatment is lower if compared with the retort, and then if we minimize the thermal damage, we can expect better food quality. Then this high pressure and temperature technology technology is a promising technology, but it's not currently implemented in the market, in the food industry, due to several market, legal and technical barriers. The main challenges are these. First of all, there is a lack of decision-making tools to allow food industry to apply safe treatments. Then the mechanism of inactivation of this bacterial spore is still a matter of discussion. The resistance of these microorganisms to this technology is highly variable depending on the process parameter and the type of microorganism, the characteristics of the food matrix. And then also the fulfillment of the LEAF requirements has not been ensured yet. On the other hand, the benefits of this technology for users and buyers in terms of safety and quality have not yet been demonstrated. Then there is still limited knowledge about the real impact of this technology on the quality of the food products. Also, we don't know what are the operational costs and the water energy consumption of this treatment. Another challenge is that we don't have suitable industrial equipment to apply this technology. Then the main critical points are the lifespan of the equipment that will be greatly lowered by the stress that the temperature due to the stress of the material of the vessel due to these high temperatures. And also another critical point is the development of thermal gradients inside the vessel, which are critical to assure a uniform microbial inactivation. And also another barrier is the lack of monitoring tools to ensure that we are applying a safe treatment. Then Hipster project was created to address some of these challenges. And then this is an innovation action funded by Horizon 2020. This project is coordinated by CNTA, but we are 9 partners from 6 different countries, 4 research organizations, 2 companies providing technology, 2 food industries, and 1 company expert in dissemination activities. Then we started our activities the 1st of March of 2015, and we will end by the end of this month. Then these have been our objectives. First of all, regarding the microbial risk assessment, we wanted to develop new knowledge about the inactivation kinetic of relevant pathogen spoilage microorganisms in food models and real food products. Then we performed some laboratory inactivation studies in order to define a process window, the temperature, pressure, and time needed to obtain safe and stable product. And then we validate this proposed treatment with studies in real food products. Then we have performed a wide range of tests with a lot of microorganisms. I'm not going to enter into detail because after me, Maximilian Mayer from TUM and Sergio Ramos from CNTA will give you more details about this inactivation kinetics. And also I have included in your documentation 2 posters that we have presented in the IFOS conference, and then you have more information in the documentation we give you. Then the second objective has been the development of an equipment at industrial scale suitable to apply this technology, this high pressure and temperature technology. Then we wanted not only to construct the HPT equipment, but also the auxiliary units for the preheating and the cooling steps, then in order to have a wall system. And also we work to develop a monitoring tool, a sensor of temperature able to work at these high pressures. And also, I'm not going to enter into details because after Benito de Orte from Metronis will explain you the system we have developed. The third objective is to demonstrate the added value of the technology. Then, here we wanted to set the quality benefits of this technology. We evaluate the impact of this technology in the food quality of the products. Then, we have done this for a lot of different products. Then, after Sergio Ramos will present you the results regarding this impact on the food quality. And then, finally, we wanted to validate, to study this, to enter more into detail about the study of the feasibility of this technology. Then we have a look at the compliance with the legal requirements and the techno-economic feasibility of the technology, and also we studied the sustainability of the technology through a life cycle assessment. And also, Geraldine Duffy from TICAS will show you something about the legal requirements, and Alexander Moreno from Actalia will show you the results of the life cycle assessment. Okay, and that's all for me, and then we can start with the most interesting presentation, showing you the results we have obtained in these objectives.